2 with that lap. And with all the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again. Verstappen, Bottas, and Lewis Hamilton. And if today's practice is anything to go by, we're in for an exceptional weekend of Formula One.
Okay, with conditions as they are, I'd suggest you take a set of full wets. Okay, there's 2 minutes left in this session and we're in the drop zone. We need a quick lap or that's qualifying over for us. Fantastic. That was the fastest lap. In the fastest lap? Good job. At least another 10 minutes until this rain evens out. Stay alert out there. The car settings screen on your multifunction display will allow you to change various settings as you drive. Open the display with the MFD button. You can then...
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today. Raikkonen, Verstappen and Sergio Perez. Goodbye for now then, but we're really just getting started. Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow. You join us in Portimao as we prepare for what will undoubtedly be a magnificent day of racing. It's time, of course, for the Portuguese Grand Prix. A lap of Portimao is 2.9 miles long, and it's made up of 15 turns, 9 right-handers and 6 left-handers. It's been described as a roller coaster with a lot of elevation changes. There's more than one blind summit, and the conditions today aren't going to make visibility any better. So drivers are going to have to be on the ball if we're to avoid a safety car here today. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today, it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of Turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
Well, the throttle goes both ways, Crofty. You've got to have the discipline not to try and win the race on the first lap. So always be prepared to lift early and give those around you more space. Trying to be the last of the late breakers with half a dozen cars around you may pay off from time to time, but it's also a great way to lose your front wing.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Kimi Raikkonen's perfect lap yesterday sees him start from pole position, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Perez, Hamilton, Charles Leclerc and Norris, Fernando Alonso, Gasly, Ricciardo and Sebastian Vettel, Bottas, Sainz, Esteban Ocon and Tsunoda, Stroll, Russell, Mick Schumacher and Antonio Giovinazzi, Latifi and Nikita Mazepin. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Okay, go through all the gears if you can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool though, so don't go too high with the revs. Getting lighter now, but it's going to take a while for the track to dry out.
Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch. Antonio is in the pits. Antonio in the pits. That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. work. That's a new fastest lap of the race. We're leading our teammate by 52.8 seconds. Definitely think we need to stay on this tyre a bit longer, but there's no question that the track is drying. We might be in a position to change soon. Some information on Leclerc. They seem to have an issue. You're doing well out there. Keep it up. We're looking at about 10 more minutes of rain. 10 minutes. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Okay, copy that. We'll be right back. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Got that confirmed? Antonio is coming in for his stop. Cars are coming in for inters. It's touch and go, but could be worth the risk. We'll be ready if you want a box. Release. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Behind us is 1.8 seconds. Good job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. It looks like we'll be running on a dry track soon. Back to dry shortly. Is drying, but it's going to take a while to clear the standing water off the line. Don't start thinking about slicks just yet. Work, that brings you up a place.
Thank you.
tyre situation is an interesting one, but I think the right call is to stick with what we've got right now. We're expecting rain in around 10 to 15 minutes. the stewards have now enabled DRS. DRS is now online. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Confirmed. Antonio is in the pits. Antonio in the pits. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Antonio is coming in for his stop. Complete, go now. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track. We're expecting some rain soon. Expect the first drops in the next few minutes. The gap to the car behind is 8.9 seconds. lapping around a second faster than the car ahead. Keep this up. These conditions are tough, but bear with it. I don't think the track is ready for intermediates yet. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Copy. Antonio is in the pits. Antonio in the pits. Go, go, go! Okay, the stewards have now disabled DRS. DRS is now disabled. Conditions are going to keep deteriorating for 10 minutes at least. Pace is strong, but be aware your tyres need to go the distance. Antonio is coming in for his stop. Nice move.
We're still happy that we're on the right tyres at the moment. The car behind has started to drop back. There's a gap beginning to form. The car behind is dropping back. We're seeing a gap form. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Copy that. Cars are definitely kicking up a lot of spray at this point. I doubt we're quite ready for the full wet, but we're not far off. Antonio is in the pits. Antonio in the pits. Our gap behind is 5.0 seconds. increasing the gap on the car behind by 5/10 per lap. These conditions don't look like they're shifting. We're predicting at least 20 minutes of heavy rainfall.
Thank you.
increasing the gap on the car behind by 5/10 per lap.
rain will be staying with us for a while now, at least a 20-minute window of heavy rain.
We'll be right back.
We're increasing our gap on the car behind by around a second a lap.
Radar suggests that this heavy rain will be with us for a while now.
about a second a lap on the car behind. It looks like a virtual safety car. Speed, our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. There's been an incident on track, but officials aren't looking to push for a safety car right now. Just be careful. Green flag. The car behind has started to drop back. There's a gap beginning to form. This is your final lap of the race. Job, you've done everything we wanted today.
They take the checkered flag then here in Portimao in what has been another outstanding Grand Prix. Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
Well, they clearly have a car that comes alive in the kind of conditions we were dealing with today. It's a very balanced package in the wet, and what that means is that the drivers have confidence to attack, and having that confidence gets you on the power earlier, it lets you brake later, and can put you a long way up the road.
So here they come now, out onto the podium. It's thrilling to see this team go toe-to-toe with the best teams in the sport and come out on top. What a superb victory from the Alfa Romeo team. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
It's got to be Valtteri Bottas, a commanding performance that I think had the audience's eyes glued to him for the majority of the race.
Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.